This section will focus about network hacking. And I think network hacking is one of the easiest topics in this course. And in general, network hacking is quite easy. And this is a problem for most network and system administrators. And we're going to take different attacks on this section. So we're going to talk about sniffing, man-in-the-middle attack, SSL stripping, session hijacking. We'll cover many, many topics. But why this specific attack is quite easy, and why it represents a challenge for us, that it's very hard to 100% secure a network. Now, when I'm talking about network, I mean two different kinds of networks, the wired and the wireless, any LAN or wireless LAN. So the network in general, the wired one, depends on some devices connected through cable to a switch. While the wireless, also it's some machine connected but through radio waves to an access point. Now, the thing with the network that we do not, most of the attack will not focus on the machine. It will focus on the switch or the access point or even the traffic. And this is why this kind of attack is very hard, hard to prevent. So, I'm connected to a network, wired or wireless, and I start manipulating the switch. I start to convince the switch that whenever traffic is going, just could you let it go through me? And it's very easy to do that. And in wireless, it's even worse because wireless are broadcasting, so sometimes you are not even a member of the network. But you still can compromise it. Wireless, we're going to take some attacks that are applicable here, and some of the attack will be applicable on the wireless section related to cracking key and so on. So hacking the network is quite easy. Now, before going through the demonstration and taking many attacks, I just need to give you an idea about how the switch is working. Switch, it's a layer 2 devices. That means it can recognize the machine by their MAC address, not by their IP. So whenever one machine needs to connect to another machine or need to connect to a router to go to the internet or need to, the switch can identify those machines by their MAC address, while machines themselves can communicate to each other using their IP. So here we have a problem. You have two people connected, or two machines are connected to a switch. Switch can exchange the information between them by their MAC address, while the computer can use only the IP. So definitely you need kind of translator to translate for IP to MAC. And this is most of the attacks that we're going to explain in this topic will be built on that, to manipulate this translator, to let them translate something else. And I'm going to share with you a comment that whenever we do an attack on the upcoming video, please always check with this comment what has been changed. So the objective, one more time, it's not just to go step by step with the tools and know how it works and to do a successful attack. This will not get you to become a successful penetration tester. It's all about understanding behind the scene what exactly is going on. So a very useful comment that I would like you to test from time to time whenever you implement an attack, it's called ARP minus E. And ARP is a protocol that translates the IP to MAC. So when you try to ping on a website, the switch will translate that to the IP, from the IP to the MAC, so he can send this request to the web router and then to the website, or from one machine to another machine and so on. So ARP minus A will show you all the translations that has been made. Now, eventually, sometimes after implementing the attack, if you go to the victim machine, you're going to find that the translation was not done correctly. So you are going somewhere, but you have been manipulated with a different MAC address that will send the traffic to the hacker machine. So my point is, please memorize this comment. And for the upcoming video, whenever we do an attack, and if the attack is successful, please investigate why it was successful. Type ARP-A and check is this the right MAC address for this specific IP? Okay, so by doing that, you get an idea about the manipulation of the ARP. And ARP can be manipulated very, very, very easily, as you can see on the upcoming video. So let's take some attacks. And whenever you do an attack and it's successful, please analyze it. And if you have any question or any things that was not clear about the attacks that you're going to take, please feel free to post a question and I'll get back to you very fast. Thank you so much.